I literally have tears in my eyes, so I have to explain this right now.
Oh!
Fuck! Okay, so I haven't picked up my camera in like 2 weeks, and I'm picking it up again right now to tell you that I'm going to the desert right now for no reason at all, other than the fact that we're both having mental breakdowns every single day lately about life. I feel like I need to solve it by surrounding myself with nature, potentially harmful
animals.
There's no
nature out there. It's just desert.
But that's still nature. That's what's going on right now. Me and Sydney are going to Joshua Tree for the night, and we're staying in like an RV that has like this cute little setup. I found it on Airbnb the other night when, once again, I was having a mental breakdown. I kind of realized the other day that now that I live out here, I can start doing like road trips to places that I've like never been. I've never really like explored the West Coast. I've done everything on the East Coast, but now I'm like, we can do fun things out here, or we can try. Me and Sydney literally don't do anything else other than just sit in my room or the living room or the kitchen, which is the same thing. Sydney lives in the kitchen, which we also need to explain that. So as you know, I've been living with Sydney since September. She was supposed to leave last week and I was telling her, no, please don't go. And then would you like to explain about your car?
Well, my car started beeping at me maybe like a month ago.
Please just ignore Sydney's messed up lash in this clip. There's absolutely no need to point it out, even though I just did that. So since I just did that, feel free to just stare at it for the entire remainder of this video. Thank you.
The seatbelt was going off, the airbag, the brake, literally every light on my dashboard was on. But everyone said, hey, if your car's still running, you can drive it. So I kept driving it. Finally, I had a drive home and I was not about to listen to beeping for 29 hours. So I decided to take it in and they said, you can take your car back in 3 days. And then it turned into 4 days. And now it's at 2 weeks.
And it costs how much to fix?
$3,600, baby. Woo!
The best part is Sydney took her car in to get fixed, and now I have to take mine in to get fixed. Would you like to explain that?
Well, when I was backing up to go take my car in to get fixed, I backed into Caitlin's car, and there is a massive dent in the front bumper. Nothing that can't be fixed.
You really said, if my car is found, so's yours. I'd like to take it to Joshua Tree for one last hurrah before it goes into the shop for what they said was 5 days. It's gonna take 5 days to fix a dent in my car.
Okay, well, join the club.
Well, I don't want to join the fucking club.
Cheers.
I'm looking forward to having a spiritual awakening in the desert tonight. Maybe I can figure out what my purpose is and what to do with myself while the world is like this, because
I'm gonna find my reasoning as to why I'm here 2 weeks past the fact that I wanted to be.
You know what?
We're Things making are gonna be the revealed tonight.
This sounds like The Bachelor opening. You sound like Chris Harrison. Tonight, the bachelors tell all. I don't know. What does he normally say?
I don't know. Hopefully we make it there by sunset.
I asked the lady if we could check in earlier than 4 o'clock and she said no, bitch. So that really sucks because the sunset is at 4:30. So we're just gonna be in the dark in the desert all night.
Did we get wood? I don't know how to make a campfire.
We literally didn't buy wood. I'm looking forward to burning cacti. Is that the plural for cactuses?
I don't think cacti burn.
I actually don't feel like starting a wildfire tonight.
The clip cuts to Josh, which you're just burning down.
Because of us. I'm gonna update you in a little bit after I stuff my face with cheese and crackers and hopefully make some improvement down this highway, because fuck, this ain't looking too hot. I'll be completely honest right now, I don't think I realized where Joshua Tree was, and of course, it's right next to Palm Springs. Now I'm at the part of the highway where all the windmills are, and you know that you're almost at Coachella, and you know that like you get to be happy, and it's like the first time in a year that you get to be here and like have fun and like whatever, but like, I'm not going to Coachella right now. These windmills don't fucking matter. I don't care about seeing them. I don't care to see them. They just don't symbolize anything in my life right now, other than when is the next time that I'm gonna be happy. That's what they're standing for. Okay, everyone, this is future me coming at you live with a proposal. So I have to do a brand deal right now, and I know this is a really awkward spot in the video for me to do it, but guess what? I'm doing it anyways. In return for you sitting through this, I am going to demonetize this video so that I can actually have good music in it. And I'm doing this one for the people. You're so welcome. And also, everyone in my house is still sleeping, so I literally can't film this inside, so I'm filming this in the garage, and there's cars going by, so you really just need to ignore all the loud noises. I can't do anything about this, and this video is due. So without further ado, thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's trip. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people to explore new skills, develop existing interests, and get lost in their own creativity. Right now, I'm currently still taking the Transforming Footage into Evocative Travel Stories class by Oliver Astrologio, which I told you guys about last time, and I love it so much because I'm still learning so much about creating better travel montages and just really capturing, you know, the moment. If you're uncertain about what's next, just like I am, creative challenges and productivity classes can be a great way to help structure your time. God, I look like shit. Oh no, my camera's about to die. Whether you're looking to fend off boredom, focus on self-care through creativity, or join a similarly creative community, Skillshare is the place to keep you learning and heading in the right direction. The first 1,000 people to click the link in my description are gonna get a free trial of Skillshare of a... of a Skillshare. We'll get a free trial of a Skillshare premium membership, and after that, it's only about $10 a month, which is worth it. Yeah. And you know what else is gonna be worth it? You sitting through this brand deal, because now we get to get back in the video. And once again, it's demonetized because I wanna use fun music. Who wants to hear Mambo number 5? All right, we are 9 minutes away from our RV and we're approaching the middle of nowhere. I officially don't know where we are. It's just this one long endless road and we have to turn soon onto our road.
I think we're going to like a haunted house.
I know. You literally gotta be kidding me. As soon as I turn the camera off, Sydney just looks at me and goes, has your car always said service transmission? No, Sydney, it has not.
I should probably stop touching cars.
I don't even know what a transmission is.
What's a transmission?
Is it like an essential piece? Yeah.
Great, so the entire car is just gonna malfunction in the middle of the desert.
So I just googled what does service transmission mean, and it says when your transmission light comes on, the best thing you can do is stop driving as soon as you can. The warning light means that your transmission is in imminent danger right now. Find a place to stop the vehicle and let it sit until your transmission is able to cool down. This is our surroundings right now, and this wants to fucking act up right now. Are you literally kidding me? It's about to be right here.
The dirt road.
Oh, God.
I am going to have a heart attack.
Please, my car needs to make it.
This seemed like a really good idea at the time.
There's car parts on the side of the fucking road. What? Bro.
Take a good long look. That's what we're gonna
look at. Shut the fuck up, Sydney! Oh my God. Wait, I think that's a street sign up there. The tire around it.
The destination is on your left.
So our address just brought us to the middle of nowhere. Shocking, I know, right?
I've watched too many episodes of Dateline. I can tell you that.
You have to back up this whole road.
Let me know if you see a car, a pedestrian, an animal. Can you play the cha-cha slide right now?
Why?
Just right here. Reverse, reverse. Do-do-do-do-do.
This is something new. The Casper Slide Part 2. We're gonna get funky. Funky.
Take it back now, y'all.
Turn it out. The sun is going down and I don't know where I am. Why is there smoke everywhere?
They're racing a go-kart.
Fun.
Should we make friends?
I'm gonna need someone to tow my car, so we might as well start being friendly now. Okay, we are here and it is fucking beautiful. Guys, please just look at this. We need to go look in the actual RV now. Oh my God, this is so cute. Here is our little kitchen. Oh, the bathroom.
Fun.
Look at this bed. This looks so comfortable.
You're gonna have to drag me out of this bad boy.
All right, quick. We have to go outside and take pictures before the sun goes down. Okay, I am literally seeing the most insane sunset I've ever seen in my entire life right now. I don't have a shirt on under this and I'm literally taking pictures like naked because I fucking can. This is the literal craziest sunset I have ever seen. Fuck, this is so beautiful. I'm so happy I did this. Okay, so we literally had less than 20 minutes here with the sun up, and now we are just sitting in the RV. I'm not sure what to do with myself. Outside of the RV smells like absolute shit. An animal literally took a dump outside the RV. I can smell it, and it's really, really strong. We were having a lot of trouble figuring out literally just how to work this. This is technically off the grid, which I'm still not entirely sure what that means other than like in the middle of nowhere, but like it's kind of hard to use the lighting and like the power and everything because I guess it's very limited. I am thinking that we make food in here really fast, go sit outside, and look at the stars. I don't know what else to do.
I'm gonna do a haul right now. We've got pretzels. We've got Trader Joe's mac and cheese.
I have this Trader Joe's cheese tray. We have pepperoni slices. Sliced cheddar cheese that you already saw in the car because I devoured like half of this in the car. 3 bags of cheddar cheese. A slice of Thousand Day Gouda cheese. We really bought so much cheese that I don't even know what to do with at this point. Pizza crust and sauce. Cape Cod chips. Bacon olive crisps from Trader Joe's. These are literally the best crackers for cheese ever. And then Sydney got rolled tortilla chips. Chili and lime flavored. Loving that for you.
They're a healthy alternative to Flaming Hot Cheetos.
Oh, I heard about that. I literally don't know why we got so much food as if we're just moving in here. I simply don't know. It's time for wine. Here we go. To us in the middle of the desert right now.
To the middle of the desert and the will to have a great time.
Woo! Holy shit, guys. I literally did spray tan last night and I had a band-aid on and we have this nightmare going on and I just didn't wipe the spray tan off my hand. I don't know. I'm a mess. Just ignore it. But since I only got these pictures today, I have decided that I am going to wake up early and I'm going to take pictures of sunrise. I mean, don't hold me to it. Please don't hold me to it because I probably won't do that. I might.
You're doing it.
Okay, Sydney's gonna make me do it. I'm gonna watch the fucking sunrise, okay? What else am I gonna do tomorrow? Fix my transmission? No, probably not. All right, everyone, it's 7:08. Just sat outside and looked at the stars. Really great time. Huge fan of the stars. Had a glass and a half of wine. So now I'm gonna make a pizza because I'm starving. Me and Sydney were just trying to figure out how to turn the heat on in this RV for so long.
I couldn't figure out how to open the bathroom door and I almost just called for help.
You just fell out.
Because I couldn't get the door open, so I was like, holy shit, I'm stuck in the bathroom.
Oh my God.
It's okay, I'm good.
Pizza time, here we go, I'm starving.
Wondering why you and I have hit it, can we
get it on. I'm trying to fit it, but I feel alright. Think about making my move tonight. I can't pretend that you're only my friend when you're holding my body tight. Cause I like the way you're making it move. I like the way you're making me wait. At the end of the night when I make up your mind, you'll be coming on home with me.
Right now.
All right, everyone, welcome back to another episode of Morons in the Wild. We just made our pizzas and we were trying to put them in and we didn't realize that this was a, what kind of oven is this? What you have to do is you have to turn a knob while also lighting something in the oven at the same time. I hope to God I just don't sound like an idiot right now. I feel like everyone on the internet is gonna be like, duh, we know how to use those ovens. But like, I personally have never used one of these before. So we just had to call Sydney's dad and he had to walk us through how to light the oven on fire while like pressing and holding a button. And I'm obviously a little bit wine drunk, so I'm a little bit more stupid than normal. I just want you to know that I'm learning new life skills and I'm getting pizza out of it. What a great 2-for-1 special.
I personally feel unstoppable right now. I could take on Joshua Tree as a whole and I could just own this place.
As of right now, we are the owners of Joshua Tree.
I mean, let's call the neighbors. You got the oven on? We're having a potluck tonight.
It's Thanksgiving, baby.
Yes. Joshua Tree.
Woo!
Oh. I mean, I'm not gonna say that looks fire, but it looks fire.
It looks pretty goddamn good.
A little bit of Monica in my life. A little bit of Erica by my side. A little bit of Rita's all I need. A little bit of Tina's what I see.
It is 9 o'clock. We literally cannot see anything at all anywhere, which is slightly horrifying.
I like had no idea it could even get this dark.
Bro, you cannot see anything past my car. And it's kind of horrifying that like any outdoor animal. Wait, what?
That's a piece of cheese?
Yeah, that's a piece of cheese. It's hard as a brick.
Why did that happen?
It's hard as a dick. I don't really know what to do with myself at this point because at this point I'm just looking forward to sunrise. And I wanted to tell you right now that me and Sydney are only friends because of TanaCon.
T-spill. Well, we were friends before that.
No, we weren't.
We met at Playlist.
I don't remember that.
I am so offended that you don't remember this.
My memory's really bad. I don't remember anything ever.
Okay, well, we met at Playlist and okay. I was working, but we crossed paths and we were like, oh my God, hi. And we were squealing in the lobby.
Oh, squealing.
Like squealing. And everyone thought that like we were like fans meeting like someone, but really we were just meeting each other.
Everyone always asked me if I actually worked TanaCon. Yes, I did.
I have trauma.
We both have trauma from it.
I was just humiliated from everything that took place, even though it was not my fault.
A year later, Sydney texted me an apology. Super nice. Really appreciated it. Then a year later, we said that we were going to go to Thailand together. We were supposed to do that around like February or March. And we literally hadn't seen each other since TanaCon. And we were supposed to fucking go to Thailand together.
Literally
Thailand. Then, you know, this year felt shit. All of a sudden, Sydney's moving into my house.
Now here we are.
And now we're in the middle of the desert.
Two peas in a pod.
She's leaving me next week. That's gonna be a fun time.
Okay, well, here's the thing is I tried leaving already and you spoke it into existence.
I said, no, bitch.
Now I'm still here.
And this is my first break from my household in 2 months. Oh, what a treat. I am so happy to literally just have breather.
Listen,
wait,
do you hear that? Not the generator. Do you hear that? It's not Johnny screaming.
What a treat.
And quiet.
We're kidding. Johnny doesn't usually scream. But who is ready for 2021, baby? Let me see those hands.
Joshua,
let me see your hands up.
Hey, who's ready for the Thailand vlog?
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. I literally wanted to go to Thailand so bad this year. I just did not get to be myself this year at all. And it's, like, kind of really fucking sad.
Hey, but we're improvising.
We are.
You're still yourself.
Right now, yes, because I'm doing something fun and like that makes me uncomfortable, which is like normally what I do. Like my brand is impulsive decisions. Like, yeah, we're relaunching the whole entire thing as a brand this week. Like, you didn't hear that from me.
I have to drive back 2.5 hours tomorrow.
Not if my transmission needs to be fixed.
Oh my God. We actually might be here multiple nights.
What the literal fuck?
We're going to a hotel, baby. Is there a Ritz-Carlton?
Bro, I hope to God. I am enjoying myself. I finally get to breathe like rich air because LA has horrible air quality. In case you didn't know, I used to live in Hawaii where like the air was really great.
Here we go.
I'm so drunk.
All right, on that note, I'm going to take a nap.
Good luck, Charlie. Fuck Amy Duncan. Oh my God. All right, I missed the sunrise. Yep, I didn't get to fall asleep until 5:30 in the morning because I thought someone was gonna bang on the window and kill me. I was literally shitting my pants. And then every time I heard a noise, I'd stay up for another 30 minutes right when I was about to fall asleep. In the midst of all that, I was wondering where my camera was. It was outside. I left it outside all night. So the murderer that I thought was going to sneak up on me probably would have taken my expensive camera first. So really happy that he didn't. Really happy that it didn't get killed. Once we turned that my generator off and I didn't have white noise in the background anymore.
It went quiet.
It went so fucking quiet. I was literally so scared because there was just no noise except like random weird noises every now and then. My dad also accidentally called me at 5:30 in the morning. The NFL theme song, of course, just started blasting, which is always a good time. He's about to call me back and tell me what my future holds
regarding my vehicle.
I don't have my voice for some reason. Like, I'm wondering if it's because the air is dry here because we're in a desert. Sydney's also eating cold pizza and sauce. We did not come prepared for breakfast at all.
I said, why don't we get cinnamon rolls? And you said, we can go to Starbucks.
Yeah, where? I literally don't know what I was talking about.
And now this is what I'm forced to eat. I either starve or I eat this.
All right, that it is. I'm gonna chug this water, maybe chug a Red Bull, and then maybe try to look presentable and take pictures before we leave because we have 2 hours. I'm gonna chug this water. It's 10 o'clock. I literally just threw on makeup and an outfit from Revolve that they sent me. It's so cute and it's so comfortable. Brown's really in this year. I'm sure you've heard every YouTuber ever say that, but it is.
Oh God.
That's cute.
I look like a Christmas tree.
No, that looks cute. It's a messy bun.
It's like sticking straight up, is it not?
That's literally how a messy bun looks. I'm starving. My dad has still not told me what to do about my car and I'm gonna take pictures to that. Cheers. All right, we're leaving and both of our phones are basically dead. Sydney's phone just died. We have to go to CVS and get one of those like things for that. Literally the only downside about this place, which was fucking amazing, is that their outlets did not work at all. And the host was just like not very helpful about that. So now we have just a ton of dead phones. My computer's dead too, because we were using that to charge our phone last night. Looking forward to not only going to AutoZone right now and seeing if we can even safely make it home. Also, we're trying to get out of here with literally dead phones. Dead phones, cars breaking down. My lips are dry as hell. It couldn't get worse. Sydney was also telling me that there's so many shoes and clothes scattered all over here. People online last night were saying things that were really freaking me out, and I think that's also why I didn't sleep. Yeah, it's safe to say this definitely was a little creepy. Still loved it. The moment of truth. Oh no.
All right. It's on.
It's got one little
rod, baby. Here we go.
Oh my God.
Great, it's blinking.
Did it just die?
I'm fucked.
It looks like you're just holding a vibrator saying,
please don't make this worse.
Should we go to Applebee's?
What? No.
Everyone gets food poisoning from Applebee's.
All right, we'll let this one sit it out.
This is really about to go one way or another. Fuck.
I think we're good. Some guy just came and checked out my car, lifted things up, pressed some buttons, and I think we're fine. Hoping for the best,
but expecting the worst.
Expecting the worst. I am so tired that like my eyes are drying up and I feel like I can start sobbing at any moment now. I am so overtired. Oh my God, I'm literally tearing up. Should I just start crying?
Can you get rich so we can get a Tesla so that way it drives itself?
Ugh, yes.
Cause it's not gonna be me.
Guys, like comment and subscribe so that I can get a Tesla so that we can sleep on the way home.
Deep chapstick again, fuck.